Three planes, two crashes, one cause. Could it be that in the 21st century, the very technology that is meant to keep us safe is putting our lives in danger?
Bank shear, bank angle. Pull up, pull up. Caution, caution.
The aircraft went into a full stall.
Bank angle, bank angle.
The captain is fighting desperately to understand what's going on.
Caution, caution.
Their chances of recovery were nil.
And dropped like a stone and hit the ground.
Could it be that the one device that's meant to be immune to mistakes is bringing planes down? Not pilot error, but autopilot error.
It's very hard to believe that I'm alive.
AM. An ordinary morning for Dutch businessman Mustafa Bacetioglu.
I was on a travel for business. I stayed there 4 days, and Wednesday I fly back.
Mustafa and his cousin are boarding a Turkish Airlines 737 on their way back home to Amsterdam.
Yeah, I fly a lot in my life, maybe 8-9 times. Per year to Turkey. Flying is one of the most safest transportation.
Mustafa has every reason to feel safe. In the cockpit, Hasan Arisan is settling into the captain's seat, as he has several thousand times before.
The flight crew on flight 1951 had a lot of experience. The captain had approximately 17,000 hours total time and about 10,000 hours in type.
In the co-pilot seat, Murat Cesaire, another highly experienced pilot. But Cesaire is relatively new to the 737. Arisan will be training him during the course of the flight. Because of the extra workload this puts on the captain, there is also another pilot on the plane.
There was a third pilot on board because the co-pilot, the guy in the right seat, was under training. The third pilot, he's there as the wicket-keeper, if you like.
And there's a final member of the team, the autopilot. The autopilot on a 737-800 is a highly advanced piece of technology. It's capable of managing almost the entire flight, from takeoff to landing. This should be as safe as flying gets.
Okay, enjoy the flight.
We're good to go.
A burst of acceleration takes the plane down the runway and up into the sky.
Yeah, you get on the plane and you fly. You eat, you drink, no problems. You don't have a fear or you don't worry about flying.
With Mustafa are 127 other Dutch and Turkish passengers. In the cockpit, all is under control. Everything is normal. Then, about 1 hour into the cruise,
the first thing what happened in the cockpit, there was an alarm sound going off.
And it keeps coming back. The horn is an undercarriage warning alarm, telling the pilots their wheels should be down. But they're cruising at 37,000 feet. There's no way the undercarriage should be down.
And as the warning horn went off, the crew discussed amongst themselves what the problem was.
Radio altimeter.
They concluded that the captain's radio altimeter had failed and that's why they were getting the gear warning horn.
There are four altimeters on a 737-800. Two pressure altimeters that work at high altitude, and two radio altimeters used close to the ground. The problem comes from Arisan's radio altimeter. It's giving a reading of -8 feet. It shouldn't even be working at this height. But it's a fairly common fault.
A faulty altimeter cannot cause a plane to crash.
It happens on the 800.
In general, the failure of one of the radio altimeters is not a big deal.
The crew ignore it and get on with the flight. In the cabin, Mustafa is relaxing. No one has any idea there's been a problem up front. Nor does anyone realize that a fatal train of events is already underway.
They are conducting the approach. Their minds are on other things.
Flaps 40, green light.
Loading checklist.
They are not watching every aspect of the flight.
Altitude set.
500.
All lights on.
And then
the stick shaker went off. The stick shaker would get everybody's attention immediately.
For some reason, the engines are powering down.
The captain would not have been expecting the throttles to close by themselves. He would have expected the auto throttle to maintain the speed dialed in the speed window of the autopilot flight director control panel.
The plane is stalling. The captain freezes.
The captain took several seconds before he actually did anything. It was too late to recover the aeroplane.
And then we fall out of the sky.